I'm living with a commercial traveller. He's away most of the time. Most I see of him is his wife. As for her, I'm just home from a show, and there I am, undressing in my shirt. I hear midnight chime, and up flares the curtain at the window. The door's opened. It's Gert. That's the wife. Her hair's hanging down. She's only got her nightgown blowing up against her in the wind. She's fat and getting fatter. I said, "What's the matter?" "Jack," she said, "now's your chance." "What chance?" I said. "You out of your mind?" She goes over to the bed. I grab my pants. "That's enough of that," I said. "Now go on, you get out." "But Jack," she said, "don't you love me?" "I don't know what you're talking about," I said. "Besides, Jim. What about him?" "Yes, Jim," she said. "There's always Jim, but he's always away. And you don't know what it's like. I can't stand it. And anyhow, Jack, don't you want me?" "Oh, don't be an ass," I said. "Look at yourself in the glass." She faced the mirror where she stood and sort of stiffened there. Her eyes went still as knots in a bit of wood, and it all seemed to sigh out of her. "All right," she said. "All right, all right. Good night." As though she didn't know if I heard, and shuffled out without another word. Well, I was tired. I went to bed and slept. In the morning, I thought I'd dreamt the whole thing. But at breakfast, I could have wept. Poor Gert clattering the dishes with a dead sort of face like a fish's. I'll have to get a new place. I'm going out today to have a look. Trouble is, she's a marvelous cook.